And so when people look at Josh, they tend to think that he's wounded or he's in pain or he's suffering. But actually, none of those things are true. And in fact, if you were to sit down and interview Josh, he would tell you that he thinks he is perfectly normal and walks just fine and does not see any differences between him and any other dogs. Josh was born with a neurological disability called cerebellar hypoplasia. It basically means that the cerebellum, which is the part of the brain that controls all motor function, is underdeveloped. He shares a lot of similarities with cerebral palsy, as well as autism and some sensory processing challenges. I think that a lot of people see Josh and think that he's really cute, but assume that caring for him and loving him is very challenging, or would somehow be a drain on their time and their resources. Since we've welcomed Josh into our home, if I'm being perfectly honest, my life has been fuller and filled with more adventure than before I met Josh. Even though I didn't think that I was equipped to handle Josh's disability, I had a really flexible work schedule and a deep desire to help him. And it turned out I was the perfect person for the job. Because honestly, I learned as I went. There really is no instruction manual on how to help a dog with a disability. A typical day for Josh involves waking up and snuggling on the sofa while I drink my coffee. Then we put on his protective booties, and then I get him into his wheelchair and we head outside for a morning walk. This is how I like to start our day. I like to encourage Josh to be active and get outside and get fresh air. We've been practicing this walk for the last year, and even though it's only a half a mile long, it takes us approximately 40 minutes to complete our entire walk. We do that every morning, and a lot of our neighbors come out and cheer him on, and I encourage him with treats. Josh also gets along with our bunny, Jared, who lives in our house, and he loves all animals that he meets. He gets along great with dogs and cats, obviously bunnies. He loves kids. He's very outgoing, and he knows when people are cheering him on, so he will ham it up for the camera and smile. But he's very human-like in that he really enjoys companionship. He just likes to sit close. He really likes massage. He likes attention, and he really likes being outside. He teaches me big life lessons every day. He's really taught me the power of acceptance and sort of just accepting the challenges that have been laid before me in this lifetime, but still having the bravery to keep pushing through on the days when I think that